Hi, and welcome back to my new video about what is continuous deployment. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox, take out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problems. Continuous deployment consists of the activities, deployment, verify, monitor, and respond. Let's have a look what we are doing there. Before continuous deployment, we have continuous exploration and continuous integration. For both, I have created videos. In continuous exploration, we have the customer and the business. They have bright ideas. Out of these bright ideas, we extract the hypothesis behind this idea and we put this hypothesis into an epic. With the epic and the hypothesis behind the epic, we go back to the customer and we try to find out what the real need or the real problem is. And we are also going to the market and going to analyze what the market needs are. After that, we are going to define the minimal architecture which is needed to prove the hypothesis. And then we are going to break down this epic into features and we put these features onto a backlog and we create a roadmap. With this backlog of features, we are going into continuous integration. First, we are going to break down these features into user stories, which we then are going to implement. The code is then committed into version control or into the source control system, and then the build server creates a deployable artifact. This deployable artifact is then verified through test end-to-end and then deployed into a staging environment where we can present that to our stakeholders. With this deployable artifact, which has been verified in the staging environment, we can now go into production and we are continuously deploying these artifacts into a production system so that we can make everything ready to be released. Why should we deploy continuously into production? When we look at traditional deployment practices, then deployment and release is the same. And we stack up all of the features for 1 month, 2 months, or 3 months, and then we deploy everything together and we release the software directly to all of the end users. This has a high risk because we don't know what has changed in these 3 months. There is a massive amount of changes in such deployments and releases, and they are highly dangerous. Therefore, we go and do continuous deployment because with continuous deployment, we can create small batch sizes, small changes, which we are continuously deploying into production. And with that, we are able to increase massively the flow of value. To do this, we need to separate deployment from release. A deployment is bringing the compiled code into production with the feature flag off. A release is switching on the feature flag so that the users can use the new feature. And this enables us to release on demand. This means that all of the changes are already in production and the business can decide when the time is right to release this feature. This increases massively the time to market. So how do we do continuous deployment? We have four activities in there: deploy, verify, monitor, and respond. I have created for each one of these activities an in-depth video where I show you exactly what we are doing in each one of these activities. So the first activity which we have in continuous deployment is the deployment into production. To do this, we need to separate deployment from release. A deployment is bringing the compiled code with the feature toggle off in production. A release is switching on the feature toggle so that we can release the functionality to the users. To do this, we need to have a feature toggle. A feature toggle is nothing else than an if statement which we have in code where we can configure if the feature is on or off. This enables us to do dark launches where we bring the functionality already in production without releasing it. When our changes or our deployable artifact has been deployed to production, we need again to verify in production that everything is okay. We do that by executing a subset of the tests which we have already executed in test end to end. If one of these tests fails, then we do an immediate rollback to the latest stable version. If everything is okay, then we can start with the monitoring. You remember back in architecture, we said we need to architect for operability. And here, all of these log statements, all of these telemetry that we have built in during the cycle, now we use that to build up our telemetry system where we can monitor our application. And as always, things can happen, shit can happen in production. And when this happens, then we need to respond to that. And we do that by setting alerts on thresholds on top of our monitoring system so that we can get alerted before the users are affected. And if something happens, then we do cross-team collaboration. We work together to resolve this issue and to ensure business continuity. When we have done all of that, then we are ready to release on demand, which will be the next step. I get always asked, how fast is this process? Let's make that very concrete. So if we have a feature and the feature gets broken down into a user story and the user story gets developed and the build server creates this deployable artifact and the deployable artifact gets verified and deployed to a staging environment. Then we have this deployable artifact in the staging environment and we can immediately deploy this artifact into production. We verify in production with a subset of the tests if everything is okay. Then we start the monitoring of if everything is still okay in production. And if something happens, then we get alerted by our thresholds and our notification system. You can see this whole process can be done within minutes or within hours. There is absolutely no need to stack up all of the changes, all of the features for 1 month, for 2 months, or for 3 months, and then deploy that in one big chunk and release everything. When we are done with continuous deployment, we have a stable production system, which has the latest changes in it. We also have built up a monitoring system where we can track all of the features, the system performance, end user behavior, incidents, and also the business value. And based on this monitoring system, we have an alerting and a notification system. And we are ready to release on demand. Continuous deployment enables us to continuously deploy new changes into production. This enables us to have small batch sizes, and we can bring with these small batch sizes smaller changes into production with a high frequency and a low risk. To do this, we need to separate deployment from release. Deployment is bringing the compiled code into the production with the feature toggle off, and releasing it is when we switch on the feature toggle. This enables the business to say when the time is right to release a feature, and this has a massive impact on the time to market. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel because I will create a video every week for you.